and welcome to another edition of What a Player Concussion Sub Series. I'm your host, Sanjay Dubey, and today we have a new concussion sub, Anil Jain, with me. Anil?
Hello, everyone. Hi there.
So for any sport, fans are really at the heart of it. They are, to me, the biggest stakeholders in the game. So we have some very interesting people from Mumbai who are part of the North Stand gang at the Wankhede. Anyone who's ever been to a game at the Wankhede, they are the noisiest people. They are the one who create the atmosphere at the ground. So we have Vipul and Ajinkya on our show. Welcome.
Hey, hi, Sanjay. Hi, Anil.
Hi, guys. Looking forward to catch up with you, yeah.
Right. This is like, you know, so real because I can relate to so much of the stuff which you guys will be doing as normal fans. So, and I'm glad that we do not have any celebrities because we can keep it very real. You can talk very freely about whatever you want. So, the first question is for you guys. What is this North Stand gang? Tell us a bit about its inception and what you guys do, because we see so many people wearing these t-shirts of NSG and you seem to have a lot of people around with you creating that atmosphere.
So Ajinkya, I'll take this up.
Yeah. You go ahead.
Yeah. So actually North Stand is the place where, firstly, a lot of cricket fans would go to North Stand. And I'm talking about old Wankhede. So, North Stand gives you the straightest view, and if you're in a stadium, you would rather have a straight view. So what happened was the best of fans started accumulating in one stand, and the old Wankhede was like the West Stand at the Borussia Dortmund, where you had a lot of fans in one stand and all of them are like really noisy, and it just became like a football crowd in a cricket stadium. And also, like, it doesn't happen in cricket, but it ended up becoming like an intimidating place to play cricket, the kind of atmosphere that Mumbai generates. There are very few venues in the world which come close to doing that. So what happened was that in 2009, but then cell phones were not allowed before that test match. So what would happen is you would meet people, but then you could not network with them. You couldn't build onto like meeting those people on match days. So what happened in 2009, there's Anish, Ashutosh, Faraz, they met on all 4-5 days of the test match, they exchanged numbers. And since then, we've been meeting, we started going together for matches, and say 3 became 8, became 15, is now a humongous number. And since 2009 till 2021, we've grown leaps and bounds. By our presence in the stadium, by our astronomical presence on Twitter, and in a lot of ways, we won't say we are the voice of a reason, but we do represent a fan which was like literally faceless for so many years in a cricket stadium, and it's great to have a podium where we can actually voice the concerns that the fans face, which. I mean, there are actually a lot of them if you've grown up in India as a cricket fan.
2009, before I moved to Ajinkya, 2009, that was the CCI game, if I'm not wrong. 294
by Sehwag. That was CCI.
So I watched that game actually. Yeah. So, but yeah, it's different atmosphere. Ajinkya, do you want to add anything more?
No, I think what Vipul mentioned was very comprehensive explanation of what North Stand gang is. So what we actually 7 people ask us, like, we want to be a part of North Stand gang. So there is no formal way of joining North Stand gang. You just come to the stadium, chant with us, sit with us, and you are a part of us. And it's like it's like a fable. Like when we say, like, don't compare us with any. We are not celebrities. Don't give us unreasonable importance. We like to say that we are those fans who stand outside a shop or TV shop, checking the score, watching the match in a crunch at a crunch time. So we are someone like those. So yeah, that's North Stand gang for you.
Great.
Guys, so the next question is, you know, you spoke about how you guys have grown leaps and bounds from 2009, but the year 2020 had been difficult, you know, for in-stadium experience. There were no matches held in India, right? So how did you guys manage to the follows that you have on, say, on Twitters or the other people? How did you manage to entertain or, you know, keep them busy?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. So I'll take that, Vipul. So 2020 was very different. We are expecting a lot of things from this year, and we're at least expecting a test match to happen in Mumbai, or at least watching some IPL or some one day international or some live cricket action, right? So it was completely a disaster, because March was the time when the lockdown started, and April was sometime in April, the IPL was supposed to start, and it was complete disaster. And then we were like clueless of when we'll be able to see live cricket. Till date, we have not been able to. We're not that fortunate that Mumbai has not got a live match yet, or they have allowed crowd. Mustaq Ali is there happening, but they have not allowed any crowds. So what we did was the best part. And we saw a lot of channels, you must remember, a lot of channels started playing these nostalgic games. Cricket Australia started playing those 2003 series games. Star Sports started playing those World Cup, famous World Cup games.
Yeah.
We too started, then we took that to next level with our handle, maybe with our Twitter audience. We started interacting, then we started doing our nostalgia tweets. We also started doing our tweets in a different manner when we say, which were more interactive, people were interacting more. Just a small attempt to connect with our audience when cricket is not happening, and connect with all age groups. So there were a lot of tweets or a lot of content we tried to generate just to have some kind of interaction with our followers. So it was who is the next best thing in Indian cricket. So someone like Rishabh Pant, or someone who is just coming in like Yashasvi Jaiswal. So we used to talk about those. Then we discussed yesteryear's heroes in our series of Throwback Thursdays, in which we focused on those cricketers who were legends in domestic cricket but were not fortunate enough to play for India. Someone like Kawaljeet Singh, someone like KP Bhaskar, someone like Amol Muzumdar. Then there was a Superhero Sunday, which obviously was on these people. Then we started generating content which actually there was no live cricket, right? So this was actually a throwback to those years when we were like we call ourselves 90s kids, and we tried to bring those moments back and bring those memories back via our tweets. And I think we received a very good response, and that was fun actually. But the real fun started when the live cricket started again with West Indies visiting England. We were so relieved to watch our live cricket. But yeah, so we actually started doing something new in lockdown, so that people are also forgetting the distress they are in, and we also are remaining connected with our followers.
I really enjoy your Twitter feeds. You know, I was just reading a couple of hours back, you guys have posted something in response to Greg Baum's article. And the last line where it says that if you look so beautiful in your dying face, you could only imagine how good you would have looked in your youth days about test match cricket, right? So that was really nice. Yeah.
Thank you so much.
So moving ahead, do you want to share any kind of stories, experience of, you know, watching matches in Wankhede? The in-stadium experience, you know, there have been good innings that I can remember in the last decade. One of them would be Kevin Peterson's 186, you know, by an non-Indian batsman coming and scoring there. Yeah. So any stories and experience you would like to share?
Oh, that was one crazy test match. So Pujara scored 100 on day one. And when Peterson and Cook got going, it did not, like, when we look back in hindsight, it comes up and we look at the highlights, we see what kind of a wicket that was. But the sheer impact of that innings was not just the fact that Peterson got that score, but the impact it had on the entire series. So if you remember the Ahmedabad test match, Ian Bell got out, he charged down to on a Pragyan Ojha delivery, and he lost his wicket. And the way Peterson batted on day three, he literally dismantled our spinners. Like Ashwin, Pragyan Ojha, Harbhajan Singh, And when he got out, like there was a sudden collapse. And we were trailing by 89, I guess. And this was just before tea. And we thought, okay, if Sehwag and Gambhir bat out for like next 30 minutes, if Sehwag sticks around for an hour, this is getting wiped out. And by the end of the day, we were 94 for 7. And there was a genuine panic. Like Kohli got out on a full toss on a wicket, which was turning square. Ashwin danced down the track and he looked one over. And in a stadium where the opposition fans hardly find their voice, the Bami Army was singing "Swan Will Tear You Apart" again. So yeah, it was really strange. But that 186 that Peterson scored, you can watch cricket as long as you want. I mean, you're not going to see a better innings on by a visiting batsman in India on that kind of a wicket. It's not just that innings, the impact it had on the series. Like we were outdone on a rank turner. In Calcutta, Prabir Mukherjee prepared a seaming track. James Anderson ran through a lineup before the Nagpur test. Our curators did not know what kind of wicket to give. And England won a test series in India. So it is one of the most difficult things in cricket is to come and win a test series in India. And England did that in some style. So, yeah. And we were very lucky to watch it. Like, we wanted India to win, but I mean, what an innings that.
Yeah, I agree. And Sanjay, I just like to add something just purely from a fan's experience and having witnessed that, those kind of innings and the second innings collapse of India. That was so like the 90s teams wherein India would like Sachin or Azharuddin would play and miss, or they would have got a beautiful delivery and they got out and the rest of the team followed and it was a sudden collapse and India would like just be all out of for 150. Having experience of that and now watching Shardul Thakur and Washington Sundar just stick there and take the attack to the Aussies, it was like we were like so proud. I don't have words to express that feeling, but it was like they just didn't give up. And there was not, that was not just one moment in the whole series. That I think the current Border Gavaskar Trophy was all the matches except that 36 all out. Yeah. Stands a testament to just the willpower and the gut these guys the had mentality. And mental strength, correct?
Yeah.
So that with reflection to that, it was so satisfying to see these guys playing such a good cricket where they're just not giving up.
Absolutely. I think, India's home record has been so exceptional. 2004, we lost to Aussies, 2012, but, I don't think any country would have such a great home record. So yeah, 2012, that innings from Peterson was absolutely brilliant.
It had to take something special for us lose the test series in India. And that was something which was very atrociously special.
I agree.
So nobody forgets in the cricket, nobody forgets because camera allows anyone to forget that innings, especially the Indian fans and the Indian commentators. He keep bringing results like my innings in Mumbai, in the rank turner's pitch and all. So he keeps mentioning about this. And rightly so, right? Yeah.
Absolutely. I wanted to touch upon something which Vipul mentioned at the start of the show regarding, fans' experience. I'll give you some personal stories. So 2004, the first time I watched a game was at the North Stand, that famous test match. It was a dead rubber, but we won with 13 runs.
Oh, where Aussies defended 106.
Modley Kartik getting those wickets. So the first experience I had was, you go into the stadium, it's like going into a jail. I'd be brutally honest. You cannot carry anything, literally anything.
Yeah.
Couldn't carry a water bottle. Cell phones were anyways just coming up. And you cannot carry food inside. And then when you go inside, and this was the old Wankhede, you do not have any, bucket seats. So it is literally like whatever you can catch is your seat for the rest of the day.
Yeah, exactly.
But the atmosphere was electric. So that was the only thing that will, keep you hooked on. If you didn't love the game, you would not come to that stadium. The things which really surprised me was the facilities, washrooms, etc. Water, 200 ml water was being sold for like 20 rupees. A vada pav was sold for like 60 rupees inside. What is your experience of, has things changed over the years, or what would you like to see as a fans? Because I've been to some, matches here in England as well, but it's completely different. The game happening is just, a thing happening at the background. People enjoy themselves. You can move freely around. You can bring stuff from outside. But in India, it seems, and I'm sure it's for most of the stadiums,
yeah,
but it seems that it's, you know, not necessarily the best of experience for the fans.
So what you said is, I mean, you couldn't have phrased it any better. In fact, in before 2012 English tour, I was reading this forum on Bamiyami where people were discussing about which venue should we go, should we not. And someone said that I watched a 2006 test match in Mumbai, probably the most craziest atmosphere, but the shittiest of facilities. So I think I'll skip it. And then a lot of people actually got like really angry. I'm like, what nonsense are you talking about? And I'm talking about Brit fans. They are like, that is one of the greatest venues in world cricket. You don't go to Mumbai for facilities. You just go there for the atmosphere. So I remember when the new Wankhede had come up, Harsha Bogle did say once on air that if there was one city where I always felt which deserved a better venue, it is this venue. And it's not that the new Wankhede, obviously it looks like a seismic upgrade that you actually have a lift in a stadium. So
yeah,
you, but and the washrooms are slightly cleaner. But see, what I always felt as a fan, a lot of people say that fans are the custodians of the game. They are the most important. But if we don't see that happening on the ground, I don't necessarily think all that is just words which you say out of goodwill. And also, I also follow other sports. And I remember when I'd gone to watch Formula One in 2011, the first one that happened in India in Noida. And when I watched, the badminton matches at Siri Fort, I could see that the chartwala was selling his chart for $50. You could roam around. Obviously, it realized that as a fan ka izzat bhi ho sakta hai. Matlab wo humne kabhi cricket stadium mein dekha hi nahi hai. Like you would bring a banner, some random day someone will take it away. Flag allowed nahi hai. Kuch bhi hota hai. And I'll tell you, I was in Ahmedabad doing my master's for a couple of years between 2009 and 11. So watching, when you're doing an MBA, it's very difficult to get a leave and come, like you can't miss more than 3 lectures out of 27. So for the 2009 match, I could just take one day off. So I watched the third day. And I remember the second off was a Mumbai match where we were playing at BKC. And I came to Bombay for that match and the gatekeeper at BKC said, allowed nahi hai, sir. And I begged him, I'm like, literally, I've come from Ahmedabad for this. It's like allowed me. So this is how fans are treated in India. So, I mean, I know, I mean, things will get better. With IPL, obviously, there's a lot of pressure on the franchises as well to actually provide a good in-stadium experience because now you are a brand in a lot of ways. You are accountable. No one wants to go to a stadium and say, listen, I'm a big RCB fan, but look at how shitty my experience at Chinnaswamy was and write a one-page article. No one wants that. So, people are going that extra mile right now. And I mean, I'm surely things can only get better. I mean, there's so much to get better.
Thank you. Anything you want to add? Moving from Thane to Wankhede to watch it, that's in itself is a trek. And then, you know, being treated that way is not going to be very pleasant.
It is actually, as Vipul said, it has got slightly better with the new Wankhede coming up. But it's a mess with the kind of security checks or the things we do in the name of security checks. So sometimes they don't even allow coins because we like throw coins to players and they might get injured. And then people are just throwing coins in some bucket near the security counter. Then they'll not allow you to wear any metallic thing. They'll not allow you to wear take anything like any banner inside. It's so tough. And then if you have any banner, it should not have any objectionable content, which might irk some of the sponsors. There are so many rules. And then we see Barmy Army getting all those stuff inside. Barmy Army, I remember, didn't get their Billy the Trumpet inside because they were not allowed to get that guy, trumpet guy inside. It's so ridiculous. It just makes the experience so weird in a bad way, right? And then there is one dhol which the MCA gets in, and that dhol or that they start playing after every four or every over. It's very irritating because it's like that guy is just following the steps which has been told by his boss without any involvement in the game. So it's very the stadium experience is not very pleasant until and unless you are very passionate about the sport. So if you are not I'm taking my wife to the stadium and she's not that passionate, she'll not love this. She'll be like, I just want to get get out of here. Like, I don't like what's happening here. So yeah, it's getting better, but we are still not there. I've seen international football. I've seen a Euro match in Paris, Stade de France, and the facilities were so good there. Like, people were enjoying their, they're just there for the game, and they're just concentrating on the game, and there was no, like, they were not sitting in cages. Then we saw Manuel Neuer coming, walking into us, and just throwing his gloves, and then people, he's greeting his fans, and those kind of things happen. We can't imagine such things in Mumbai or India, for that matter, in a cricket.
Actually, what we're saying is not just Bombay specific. Like, I mean, I've been to like 9 venues, and I would never want to talk about my Firozshah Kotla experience. So, I mean, it's the same. Like, no matter whichever venue you go to in India, barring say a DY Patil is slightly better. Nagpur, I haven't been to the VCA, but the seats are great.
And Pune, everybody knows the parking scene there. If you have not been to, because there was a joke going around on Twitter. Someone cracked a joke that England series 3 1-day internationals are happening in Pune Stadium because it's so difficult for you to reach, let alone COVID. COVID will not even be able to reach there. So,
all we can hope is that, you know, there will be a time where, you know, there's much more better facilities for the fans and all we can enjoy, you know, not being in a difficult situation.
Sure,
I want to slightly move on to a more serious topic. So, you know, in the recently, you know, concluded Australia series, we had lots of, you know, news coming around how fans were hurling abuses or racial comments, etc. Now, I'm sure every, you know, true cricket fan around the world would not subscribe or, you know, condone that, but there would be 5 or 10 people who are probably creating this nuisance. Would you have any you know, experiences of such people in there? And is there any way you would handle it? Because I'm sure you can't control everyone, but, you know, if there's that atmosphere, people get carried away, you know, say something which may not be appropriate. Any sort of comments or experience on that?
So I'll start with the North Stand experience. So if you've been to Wankhede in 90s or early 20s, you would have seen North Stand was the most hostile place to play in front of. So anyone who is the bowling, if the bowling is happening from the Tata end, and there is someone fielding in front of North Stand, it was not a very pleasant place for a foreign player to field. And there were all kinds of things which used to get said, not exactly racial, but they were not so pleasant for a cricket fan to say. But see, and they all know the famous story where Andrew Simons was, they say he was abused. So there are fans, and there are not all fans are like that. And obviously, there are not only Australian fans which do that. That happens all over the world, I think. There are people you will meet in all walks of life who will react in some way to some situations. And there are some people who take it too far. And there are some people who keep it limited to the banter. So we don't support such kind of behavior. But we don't don't believe that only Australian fans can be categorized like that. There are people all around. You can have that countless memories. The famous one being 96 World Cup when India was losing in the semi-finals, and the fans started throwing bottles. That kind of behavior is also not acceptable. Not racial, but not acceptable. Right? You are there to support your team or there to watch a game. Just don't get involved. That's what we think as a group, and we are there to enjoy the game. Just go there, support your team, enjoy the game. If somebody like Kevin Peterson bats like that, you just have to stand up and applaud. You can't do anything else rather than you can't just go and abuse him. It will be so foolish for you to do that.
And also, the state associations have also upped their game. So I know that after the 2007 disgraceful incident of Andrew Simons that happened, for 2009, I remember Mendes was near the boundary and someone tried sledging him, and you had an official who walked in and ushered him out. Now, yeah, so things like that has happened. It also sends a good signal that there has to be this bit of policing, because no matter whatever, however that cricketer is, he is still representing his country. Even if it's a domestic match, everyone deserves that bit of respect. So racism is definitely not on.
Absolutely.
And, you know, rightly they say Siraj is the right thing. You know, he actually is a hero by pointing it out to the official and to his captain. Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah, absolutely.
And I think the times are changing. This was very, very, very common in the 80s and 90s when Dennis Lilly used to bowl. So yesterday I was reading the article and we tweeted about it. So tweeted about that match, Australia versus Pakistan in 1981. When Dennis Lilly was ferocious at his ferocious best, and the Wacker crowd, his home crowd, was hurling abuses, and they were like very, very hostile towards Javed Miandad. And then there was one incident when Javed Miandad was crossing, and he just there was some physical this between those two, and then Dennis kicked and Javed ran behind him. So yeah, those things don't happen right now. So in the recent future, we have seen someone like AB de Villiers getting chanted in a match where he was playing against India and he was absolutely belting it all over the place. So we have changed, like in the crowd in India has changed. Yeah. I think thanks to the IPL, a lot of credit goes to that. We can't say mature, but we can accept our defeat now. We can accept people playing well. We know how to upload them.
Great. Now, we move on to a bit of quiz. Should we do one by one? Anil, you take one question and then I do the next one.
Yeah, I think the first one is a very easy one. How many different test venues Mumbai has had criteria to have hosted at least a test? And you have to name those venues.
Yeah. So there'll be three.
Yeah.
So the first ever test match played in India was at the Bombay Gymkhana. Then cricket moved to the CCI or the Braddon Stadium. And in 70s, we have the Wankhede. So, yeah.
Vipul's going to absolutely kill it. So, we'll be very embarrassed.
That's like a lot of pressure. Don't say that.
yes, this is going to be, you guys know stuff inside out, especially Vipul. I don't know. Let Ajinkya try one. Come on, Ajinkya.
You're okay. Nice. Yeah, I'm there.
The next one is, what's the highest test score by an Indian at the Wankhede?
Virat Kohli, 235.
That's a very, very easy one.
We saw it. So
we saw, yeah. And we saw the big screen. I still remember the big screen showing it.
Okay, which was the...
Ajinkya, can you show him that line on the T-shirt?
Yeah, it's somewhere here.
Yeah.
If you can see, I don't know.
Near
the Dhoni. Yeah.
Oh, brilliant, man. Brilliant. That's six.
Next one, I would just keep it very short. You know the moment of 2002 ODI versus England? The last match where it was, so what was the exact moment? Yeah, what moment I'm talking about? What happened there?
You're talking about Flintoff taking his shirt off, it was a great, great atmosphere. And then England just stole that match in the end, and then Dada gave it back at Lord's. Yeah,
nice.
What is the score line, Vipul? I'm sure you know that.
That's too much of pressure.
it was a six games series, oddly, and it ended up in 3-3.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Okay, you're talking about the series score.
Yeah.
Oh, I thought about the match.
No. I tricked you, I think.
Yeah.
Might have just remembered that, and might just answer that also.
Okay, the next one is again probably an easy one for you guys. Who was the only batsman to get 100 on his debut at the Wankhede test?
Oh, so this is only batsman on test debut at Wankhede. So this is that India England test match. I think it is Jennings. Yeah,
Keaton Jennings.
Absolutely.
Absolutely.
So how many hundreds that Sachin has at one today? And you have to tell me the splits between ODI and test.
Okay, so one ODI, which was the Mohinder Amarnath benefit match, where he actually also played the reverse sweep of Nicky Boy. Test match, again one, the one at against Sri Lanka in 97.
Yeah.
That's absolutely right, yeah.
I'm going to add on one more question just because you are absolutely, you know, killing it. Who was the last test batsman to get 100 at the Wankhede?
Last test batsman to get 100 at Wankhede? Jayanth Yadav.
Damn.
Guys, we should... Good. Yeah, so with that quiz, what happens is we've had different guests, having killing a lot of these... this quiz questions, yeah. But then we have some who are absolutely not able to get it. So we try and keep a balance, but we knew that you would be, ensuring all the questions are answered.
Subjective question, which one was better, Kohli's 235 or Kevin Peterson 186?
Peterson's,
I would say Peterson 186, yeah. Any day, because of the magnitude it had and the
impact it had on the series.
Yeah. It took that innings for England to win a test series in India. That was a single-handed effort.
Great.
We follow our team passionately, but yeah, we aren't deluded.
Right. This has been fantastic, guys. You know, really appreciate your time. You guys have been really generous with your time in the afternoon. We also had a chat recently with Bami Army fans. So if anyone wants to check that video out. But thanks a lot, Ajinkya and Vipul. Look forward to maybe having you back. And if I'm in Mumbai sometime, I'll try and, sneak into the North Stand and maybe, see one of you guys or both of you.
Yeah. Can we also ask a counter question?
Absolutely, go for it.
Okay, simple one. Which is the highest? Who scored the highest ODI score at Wankhede? I'll give you a clue. Oh yeah, it is Jayasurya. Yeah.
Yeah, he's the yeah. I just remember that it was probably Jayasurya.
No, it's ironic. Like it came in the 90s. Like and now Wankhede is like that. Earlier it was like that red soil 270 par score, and now even though 400 has been made in an ODI, that still remains the highest score.
Fantastic. We should have a proper quiz session just with you guys, have some sort of a quiz series running around, but
I think Vipul would do a better job than me.
we'll keep Vipul as the quiz master so that he doesn't win it, because it looks like he'll probably
yep.
Okay,
so we've got some really good people in the gang who will do it, so the kind of bench strength India has, like our bench strength probably is equally good. Yeah.
So there is this WhatsApp group where we actually discuss our cricket, and some of the times the discussions happen on that group are so like you just sit in awe, like people remember that. So there is one guy who has newspaper cuttings since last 20 years, and every time something happens, he just like pulls it up in like couple of minutes time and like takes the pick and flashes it on the group. It's like crazy.
Oh dear, I'm sure we can go on and on about this, but I'm going to try and end this here. So thank you very much again, Vipul and Ajinkya and Anil. And for our viewers, if you like to happen this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't done so already, please do subscribe to our channel. Also check out for other video contents you may like. Drop in a comment. And we really appreciate your feedback.